that he left in the house was a crumb that was even too small for a mouse. Then he did the same thing to the other Who's houses, leaving crumbs much too small for the other Who's mouses.
You nauseate me, Mr. Grinch, with a nauseous super nauseous. You're a crooked, jerky jockey, and you drive a crooked horse, Mr. Grinch. Your soul is an appalling dump heap, overflowing with the most disgraceful assortment of rubbish imaginable. Mangled up, entangled up knots. You're a foul one, Mr. Grinch. You're a nasty, wasty skunk. Your heart is full of unwashed socks. Your soul is full of gunk, Mr. Grinch. The three words that best describe you are as follows, and I quote, stink, stank, stunk.
It was a quarter of dawn, all the Who's still abed, all the Who's still a snooze, when he packed up his sled. Packed it up with their presents, their ribbons, their wrappings, their snoof and their fuzzles, their tringlers and trappings. Thousand feet up, up the side of Mount Crumpet, he rode with his load to the tip-top to dump it. To the Who's he was grinchily humming. They're finding out now that no Christmas is coming. They're just waking up. I know just what they'll do. Their mouths will hang open a minute or two. Then the Who's down in Whoville will all cry, boo-hoo. That's a noise, grinned the Grinch, that I simply must hear. He paused, and the Grinch put a hand to his ear. And he did hear a sound rising over the snow. It started in low, then it started to grow. This sound wasn't sad. What? This sound sounded